EA Sports. It's in the game. This year in NCAA football, we've added new features to the offensive and defensive side of the ball to help you take your game to the next level. Let's start with offense. Now, when you're a quarterback in the pocket, you can avoid oncoming pass rushers using the new QB avoidance stick. If you want to sidestep a defender in any direction, simply pull the right analog stick in the direction that you wish to sidestep. This should buy you that little bit of extra time that you need to get the ball off. If a defender engages you while you're attempting your sidestep, your chances of breaking the sack attempt will be increased. When you roll out of the pocket, your quarterback will be able to direct wide receivers running downfield using the receiver direct feature. Once out of the pocket, you'll know which receiver you can direct because you'll have a colored player indicator under his feet. To direct the receiver, pull the right analog stick in the direction that you want the receiver to go. This will allow you to send the receiver towards the hole in the zone and hit him downfield for a big gain. The quarterback isn't the only player that's gotten some new moves this year. Ball carriers are now able to do highlight stick moves to run over defenders or slip by them. To use highlight stick, simply flick up on the right analog stick as the defender is closing in for the tackle. Your ball carrier can either truck a smaller, weaker defender or evade a bigger, stronger one. You have to time your highlight stick right, or else you'll whiff, and more than likely, you'll get tackled. With these offensive moves, you'll be more of a threat to go the distance on every play. So I hope to see you in the end zone more frequently this year in NCAA 08. On the other side of the ball, we have given the user some new defensive hot routes. This will give the user more options when trying to adjust on the fly to defend against what the offense is doing. With the QB contained defensive hot route and the smart zone defensive hot route, you'll be able to do a better job against mobile quarterbacks and against defending passes in critical down situations. Let QB contain first. To give one of your defenders a QB contain assignment, simply switch to the defender, then flick down twice on the right analog stick. You'll see that your defender has a black arrow pointing towards where he's going to position himself when the play starts. Once the ball is snapped, the defender will rush wide and sit outside of the pocket waiting for the QB to try to scramble. Once the QB does step out of the pocket, your defender attacks. This can be very effective in situations where you know your opponent is going to try to roll out. That quarterback will be in for quite a surprise when he finds a defender waiting for him. Now let's check out smart zones. To give one of your defenders a smart zone assignment, switch to the defender and flick up twice on the right analog stick. This will cause the defender to play his zone at the first down yard line. Smart zone takes away holes in the defense where the offense would normally be able to fit a pass into for first down yardage. Now you can have your safeties playing deep and have linebackers or cornerbacks in smart zone to ensure that you don't give up a pass at the first down yard line in critical situations like third and long or fourth down when the opponent has to go for the first down. Well, now you should be armed with enough weapons to take your game to the next level in NCAA 08. Good luck. NCAA Football 2008 has restructured the look of Dynasty, implementing some new features and reassessing some old ones to increase the amount of user control. First off, the preseason's been relocated to allow more coaching decisions to be made before the start of the season. Redshirting players and customizing the upcoming schedule will both be available in the preseason and will join the first phase of in-season recruiting, which will allow the coach to target the best 15 prospects early on and fill the team's in-season recruiting board for the upcoming year. The repositioning of this feature will also allow coaches to assess their recruiting points during week one before any games have been played. The final preseason task is called summer training, which is new to NCAA and will allow the user to perform in drills against CPU and earn points that can be applied to the player's attributes. For instance, performing well with a running back in the Oklahoma drill will allow the user to add points to that player's carry or break tackles rating, do well in the passing distance drill, or see your quarterback's throw power go up, and so on. This is the year to take control of your player's progression during the all-important preseason and lay the groundwork for a successful regular season. The Dynasty main menu has been slightly reorganized to appropriately group the extensive information and options that are at your fingertips, including coaching duties, ESPN covers and articles, stats of all sorts, and settings and save load options. Also included in Dynasty mode is one of our newest features, Lead by Example, which includes a leaderboard that lists the most effective and successful players for every user-controlled school. A report card also appears within the Lead by Example menu, which grades each user on their in-game contributions in five different but general areas: passing, catching, running, tackling, and covering. The goal here is to encourage in-game user control in an effort to show off all the incredible gameplay additions and improvements in this year's NCAA. During the in-season recruiting process, coaches will notice a new wrinkle when prospects request that certain stipulations be met before they commit to a school. A top recruit may want a specific jersey number, or maybe he prefers to only play receiver, and coaches will have to comply if they want to sign the player in question. Perhaps the promise is as simple as providing the prospect with sufficient playing time during their freshman year. But be careful, break a promise, and the player will likely transfer to greener pastures in the offseason. Medical redshirts will be another method to manage the roster this year, as injured players that meet certain conditions will be allowed to save a year of eligibility and still fulfill their dreams of playing college ball without losing a whole season's worth of experience. Another feature improvement is the ability to specify not only the recruiting pitch intensity, but the actual recruiting activity as well. Think your prospect is concerned purely with academics? Perhaps he'd like a tour of the new campus library. Or maybe the coach is the main reason that the top quarterback in the country wants to visit. Well, why not have him over for a home-cooked meal at the coach's house then? Along with the in-season recruiting visits, the off-season also provides similar opportunities for the coach to tailor his visits to the prospects. I'm sure that a highly regarded running back out of SoCal might be mighty impressed to meet a current NFL player and alumnus from your school. Or maybe talking up the kid's parents and pointing out your school's focus on graduating would be the most effective selling point. The decisions are yours this year, so take full advantage of all the new opportunities in Dynasty mode and become the next legendary coach with NCAA Football 2008. Good luck.
The very elite players are remembered as all-time greats by their schools. In the new Campus Legend mode, you'll need to excel both in the classroom and on the gridiron if you want to be enshrined in your school's Hall of Fame. In this mode, you will live the life of a student athlete, from performing drills for scouts to selecting your school and even selecting your major. Be sure to pick a major that interests you, because if your grades start slipping, you'll face being suspended by the head coach. Once you have moved into your dorm room, keep track of how you're doing both athletically and academically by looking at your progress report. Here you'll see if you need to spend more time hitting the books, if you're meeting the goals your coach has set for you, how many formation bonuses you have earned during practice, and what your popularity on campus is. Keep a close eye on your campus popularity meter. This will show you how far you have to go in order to become a Hall of Famer once your collegiate days are over. The calendar will keep you up to date on what you have to do each day. Here, you can keep an eye on what games are coming up, when your midterm and final exams are, the team's practice schedule, and how you spend your evening free time. Do you have what it takes to become a campus legend?
There are two different kick meters, one for field goals, punts, and kickoffs, which we will go over first, then there is one for onside kicks. First, with the directional buttons or the left analog stick, move your kick arrow to the desired direction and angle. This will update the accuracy meter while you move the stick arrow. Be sure to take the wind and distance into account when you're setting up your kick arrow. When you are set with your direction and angle, you can start the kick by pulling back on the right analog stick. Notice the accuracy meter before you start the kick. You will need to pull down and push up within the accuracy zone to get an accurate kick with the right analog stick. Once you pull down, the power meter will start. Once you push up, the kick meter will lock in your power and accuracy and show you how the final motion you used ended on the screen so you can see the accuracy of your movements. Onside kicking does not have the accuracy meter, but a display of the ball. Move the cursor on the ball where you think you will get the desired bounce to get your team the onside kick. The higher up in the ball you kick, the more bounce you will produce. The more power you use, the bigger the bounce and the further the kick will go. Just as with all the other types of kicks, pulling down on the right analog stick will start the kick meter, and pushing up on the right analog stick will lock in the kick. Accuracy is dependent on where you place the cursor to kick the ball from. When you're kicking a field goal or punting the ball, you have the option of aborting the kick by pressing the L2 button. You can use this feature when you think your kick will be blocked or if you want to fake a kick. When you press the L2 button, the kick will be aborted and you can either run or pass. Be careful when you're aborting the kick. If you fail or get your kick blocked, the other team could turn to tie the game against you. We have also added numerous new trick plays for your disposal on special teams. Old-time favors like the punt rooski, as well as kick return reverses, option fakes, and many more. Try these out when you think you can fool your opponent.